The word of God is alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing center of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrow. And it is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. All scripture is God-breathed and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, or accurately handling the word of truth. Dear brethren, the trends that are going along in the church age today, though they have been given a great privileges of all time, the believers have become absolutely infringed by the responsibility to have an impact of an invisible hero in this angelic conflict. The only reason is many ministers have neglected the responsibility to teach to their listeners Bible doctrine, but instead they go at them to become involved in emotionalism, personality cults, church programs, social work or political activisms. And trends in Protestant Christianity show signs of an imbalance that emphasize the visible at the expense of invisible, the material at the expense of the spiritual, the believer's overt image at the expense of the inner dynamics of Bible doctrine in the soul. The problem takes root in ignorance of dispensations. The overwhelming majority of Christians do not know what God has provided for them in the polity of privileges, or why He has given them so much. After salvation, what? What does God desire the Christians to do or hear or desert? If believers do not realize that they belong to the royal family of God, how can they fulfill their destinies? How can they execute the protocol plan of God for the church age if they do not know such kind of a plan exists? Ignorance undercuts every good intention, dear brethren. No matter how a Christian desires to make his life count for God, if he is ignorant of God's plan, he fails to glorify God. At best, the impact of his life is fleeting, no sooner achieved than dissipated. At worst, his impact is for evil, as he inadvertently struggles in Satan's cause to improve this devil's world. Dear brethren, just have a word about these things, because it is quite essential for us to note that we are united with Christ forever, and the Trinity indwells our bodies. In the face of this astonishing truth, we should ask a profound reverence. After salvation, what? The simplified answer will be to learn Bible doctrine. Church age doctrine sets forth the protocol of Christ's royal family. In mystery doctrine, we learn the portfolio God established, that is the riches in Christ, for personally, for each of us in eternity past, individually, each and every individual believer. The portfolio contains outright gifts from God that define the scope of freedom, of our freedom and responsibility of spiritual one and the spiritual responsibility. We are the aristocrats of heaven residing on earth. We are royal priests. We are royal ambassadors. We have an unprecedented opportunity to utilize this divine power, and God stands ready to enlarge our already vast resources. If we learn, understand, and apply His word, He will stimulate our own desire to know Him and lead us into eternally meaningful service and lift us above our sufferings. We have been here called to go for an eternally meaningful service. We are not being called for any of XYZ trends, but rather we have been called for a great eternal meaningful service, and that is the work of a pastor teacher, and that is the work of each and every believer to qualify each and every member of his members for this, to who believes in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for this eternally meaningful service. And then He will create an impact with our lives. That is what our Lord God the Father will do, that will resound throughout time and eternity. That's the power. A resound throughout the time and eternity, wherewith our Lord God Almighty will have an impact. Our royal destiny is to become invisible heroes in the most intense and challenging dispensation of these trends of human history. Therefore, dear brethren, we need to note what is this, the divine omnipotence, wherewith now we can live in the power of the resurrection of Philippians 3:10. Devices are now found in the operational divine dynasphere, which belongs to every church age believer. And every church age believer, which has been John 14:15 through 17, 16, 13 through 14, 1 Corinthians 6:19 through 20, we are commanded to put on the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Romans 13:14, to have Christ formed in us, Galatians 4:19, to have Christ at home in our hearts, Ephesians 3:16 and 17, to exalt Christ in our bodies, Philippians 1:20 and 21. Therefore, the plan of God for the church age believer is a supernatural plan that demands a supernatural means of execution, which is nothing but the mental ministry of Lord God, the Holy Spirit. The infinite power of God therefore goes silently into effect in our lives when we follow the mandates of His protocol plan. This system of divine power, available only to the church, can handle any difficulty in our lives and will glorify Christ as in no other dispensation. Dear brethren, ponder over these things, as we shall continue in the next tape. Father, we are grateful for the privilege that was given to fellowship with you through the word. We pray that Lord God, the Holy Spirit, will enlighten us in these things and make it a blessing and challenge our own Lord. Father, we ask in Christ's name, Father. Amen.